शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति 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 यो ब्रह्माणमिदधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोत्तस्मै तवमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्येऽं शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्री चिद्घनगणेश नमो मह्यं सुकनित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यस्तु निर्गुणापारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमः तदेवाहन्नमत्वनिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Yeah. So continuing with the teaching in Agrudha Devasya Swapna, the Acharya is explaining the Nayayika Mata and how that is not valid. Antakkaranameva Kartru Bhoktru Cha Tachya Antakkaranam Nana Madhyama Parimanam Chaiti Vedanta Siddhanta Katanam. So Nayayika Paksha was refuted as to Jnana, which is Chetana, Jnana making the Jada Atma Chetana, that was refuted through any kind of Sanyoga of Atma, Nana Atma with Nana Padartha. Thereby, Kartutva Bhoktutva also, Sukha Dukkhadi, all this is denied, Dharma of Atma. Antakkaranamiyo kartru bhoktru cha. Antakkarana is karta and bhokta. As per Siddhanta, Vedanta Siddhanta, tachya antakkaranam nana madhyama parimanam cha. Atma is not nana, but antakkarana is nana, upadhi is nana. What is the size of this antakkarana? It is not anu. Manas is not anu parimana, the way Nayayika say, it is madhyama parimana. So there is misunderstanding all the way. So Vedanta Siddhanta is, so Vedanta Siddhanta tu antakkaranam eva kartru bhoktru cha. We know this. Tachya antakkaranam nana. That also we know. Tachya antakkaranam na vyapakam na api anu. What is the size of this antakkarana, sukshma sharira? It is neither all pervasive. Had it been all pervasive, it would be one. And it is not even a minuscule size, of a minuscule size. Kintu sharira parimanakam. It expands to the size of the sharira. Whichever sharira the sukshma sharira associates with, it takes the size of that sharira. So it expands and shrinks based on the stula sharira samanda. Deepa prakashavat antakkaranam brihat sharira praptau vikasati. Expands like light, expands based on whichever room it is contained. Alpa sharira prapto sankuchati cha. And if the body is small, in an ant's body, the antakaranam is smaller than in a human body or an elephant's body. Ayam artha siddhanta bindau madhusudana swami vi pratipaditaha. This topic has been dealt with by Bhagavan Madhusudana Saraswati in Siddhanta Bindu. Yasya antakkaranasya yena sharirena sambandho bhavati, tasya antakkaranasya tasmin sharire bhogo bhavati. So the antakkarana connecting with the stula sharira, sukshma sharira having stula sharira sambandha, based on whichever stula sharira, thereby there is bhoktrutvam of that sharira. There is bhoga of that stula sharira krita. Whatever is done by that stula sharira, that bhoga is there in the associated antakarana. अंतःकरणस्य व्यापकत्व स्वीकारे सर्व शरीराणि सर्व साधारणे भवेयुः भोगोपि सर्वेषाम् आपद. इफ यू टेक द मनस एज व्यापक इति नैयायिक पक्ष, देन सर्व शरीराणि सर्व साधारणे भवेयुः. ऑल शरीरास विल बी एसोसिएटेड विद एंड देन विल हैव द सेम फ्लॉ दैट नैयायिका हैज. भोग अपी सर्वेशाम आपद्येत. वन शरीर है सुख दुख, दी मनस एसोसिएटेड विद दैट सुख ऑफ दैट शरीर विच एवर इज ड्यू फॉर दैट पर्टिक्युलर प्रारब्ध कृत शरीर, दैट विल बी अनुभूत बाय अदर्स ऑल्सो. अंतकरण से व्यापकत्वासीकारे नैष दोषो भवति. इफ यू टेक अंतकरण as not being vyapaka. Now what is the difference there? Nayayika says atma is vyapaka. So whatever flaws accrue to atma being nana and vyapaka, same flaws will accrue to antakarana being nana and vyapaka. So antakarana is not nana, antakarana is nana but not vyapaka. Then such flaws will not exist in the Vedanta Siddhanta. अंतकरण से व्यापकत्व अस्वीकारे. When you don't take अंतकरण as व्यापक, there can be nana. अंतकरण can be many and still नैष दोषो भवति. अंतकरण से अणुपरिमाणत्व स्वीकारे शरीर एकदेशे अंतकरण से स्थितिर्वाच्य तथोक्तिरपि असंगता. And in the नैयायिका पक्ष it was also refuted that antakarana being anuparimana, what will happen if there is dukkha in one part of the sharira, there is a pain in one part of the sharira, the manas has to be exactly there. And assuming that it is exactly there, or wherever the manas is, there itself the hurt is, then the other hurt cannot be anubhuta, you cannot know the other pain. बट अंतकरण से अणुपरिमाण तो स्वीकारे शरीर एकदेश अंतकरण से स्थिति रिवाच. इट शुड बी एक्सप्लेन्ड एज बीइंग इन वन पर्टिकुलर प्लेस. तथोक्तिरपि असंगता वाय तथा सति युगपदेव पादे मस्तके च कंटक वेधे सति द्वयोरपि स्थानयोर युगपदेव अनुभूयमाना पीडान उपपद्येत. वी हैव सीन दिस एज यू कैनॉट हैव अनुभव ऑफ पेन एज एन एग्जाम्पल in multiple places of the sharira. If antakarana is anuparimana, it has to be in one particular place. Yadi antakaranam anu tad, the typo here, tada should be only one. So tada tad ekasmin yasthane se, no, antakaranam anu then tat. So we can say yadi antakaranam anu syat tada तद अंतकरणम एकस्मिन काले एकस्मिन एव स्थाने स्या. दी अंतकरण वुड बी ओनली इन वन प्लेस. ततश्च यस्मिन स्थाने अंतकरणम स्थितम तत्रैव पीडा अनुभव युज्येत, नत्तु द्वयो स्थानयो युगपदेव पीडा अनुभवस्य युक्तिरस्ति. सो इट्स एन एलाबोरेशन ऑफ व्हाट वी ऑलरेडी सॉ. तस्माद् अंतकरणम न अणु नापि व्यापकम्. इफ अंतकरण इज अणु देन यू कैनॉट हैव युगपद पीडा अनुभव. If antakarana is vyap, you cannot do away with sukha dukkha anubhava one sharira pervading unto another antakarana. You cannot limit it to a particular sharira. So you have flaws if you take antakarana as anu and also if you take as vyapak. So antakarana is something in between. What is that? It is of the size of the sharira. So if it is not anu, it is expanding to the sharira, then whatever flaws are there in the antakarana being anu, particularly what? Yugapad, pida anubhava. That won't be there in the paksha of antakarana pervading the stula sharira. So wherever in the stula sharira there is pida, antakarana vritti is possible of that pida. But it does not go beyond the sharira. So anakha paryantebhya, antakarana will not go beyond the stula sharira. Then what will happen? You cannot have anubhava of other stula sharira. So the dosha of vyapaka antakarana or vyapaka atma in the case of nayayika, that won't be there. Now we also have vyapaka atma. However, that vyapaka atma is not nana, it is one. Then how is the sukha dukha anubhava different? Because the antakarana is limited. Kintu sharira samana parimanakam ataha na kopi doshaha anuvyapakabhyam yad vilakshanam tan madhyama parimanakam iti kathyate. So what is this called which is between anu and vyapaka? That size antakarana is called as madhyama parimanakam, middle size. And that size is as per the stula sharira. Atmana madhyama parimanatva vadimata nirakaranam. Now antakarana is of varying size. It is flexible. It fits the stula sharira as per the prarabdha due for a particular jiva. Now there are some who say it is not this antakarana which is changing size, but atma is changing size. Jainas say that. There are some nayayikas who say that. So what we have explained as Siddhanta, they extend it to Atma instead of limiting it to Antakarana. So Atma is neither Anu nor Vyapaka, like Antakarana in Siddhanta. They say Atma itself is Madhyam Parimana. Atma shrinks and expands the size of the Sharira. That's what the meaning would be. Now that is refuted. Atmana Madhyam Parimanatto Vadi Nayayika Mata Kathanam. So Nayayika is mentioned here, but even Digambaras, Jainas also have the same understanding in their darshana. Nyayamate kechana navina eva mahuhu. So there is some Navya Nayayika who says Atma nana karta bhukta cha. That much is same as the old Nyaya. Natu vyapakaha, there is a difference that Atma is not vyapaka the way the Puro Paksha Nayayaka said, but it is Madhyama Parimana. Ataha na bhoga sankaryam, na api anuhu Atma. Atma is not even anu. Ataha ubhayatra antaveda janya pidanu hava sambhava dosha api na. Since it is Madhyama Parimana, you don't have the dosha of not having Yugapat Pida Anubhava. It can have because the Atma pervades the entire Sharira. Kintu Yatha Vedanti Mate Antakarana Madhyama Parimanam Tatha Atma Api Madhyama Parimanam Bhavati Tasmin Atmani Chaturdasha Gunas Santi Iti. So all these Gunas which are talked about in the old Nyaya system, they are there in Atma also, in Atma in the Navya Matha also, but still Atma is neither Anu nor Vyapaka, it is Madhyama Parimana. Like the Antakarana in the Vedanta Siddhanta. Purvokta Mata Nirakaranam. So there is a tippana here. Yatha Nana Ghatanam Vyapakatvangi Karaha Nishpalaha Tata Prati Shariram Kartruvokta Rupa Nana Atmanam Vyapakatvabhyupagamaha Nishpalaha. There is no prayojana in accepting. Not just like Nana Ghata brings no. See, Nana Ghata, if you take Nana Ghata, then Nana Akasha is not needed to be accepted. But here, how is it presented? Yatha Nana Ghatana Vyapakatva Angikara Nishpalaha. You need not take each and every Ghata as expansive. You can limit it to a particular area. Still, the Akasha can be explained to be there in particular ghata akasha, but it's explained in a little different manner. Let us not get confused with it. What is being said is that kartrutva bhoktrutva rupa nana atmanam vyapakatva abhyupagama nishpalaha. You need not take this atma as Vyapaka and Nana. So you, if you take it as Nana, then Vyapakatva need not be mentioned. And this is what the Navya Nayayika is doing there. Athava Nana Antakkarana Abhyupagamenine Eva Bhoga Sankariya Siddhehe Vyapakasya Atmana Nanatva Angikara Nishprayojana. And what Vedantin does is that Antakkarana, if you take it as many, then you need not have the Atma as many. Atmana Nanatva Angikara Nishprayojana Nishphala. There is no additional benefit of it. So there is Gaurava, and with Gaurava, if you get some more benefit, it is okay. In Tarka Shastra, it is acceptable. But if you are not getting any benefit of a complicated philosophy, can be attained with a simpler philosophy, then by Occam's razor, Laghavam is preferable. Gaurava dosha can be avoided. Purvokta mata nirakaranam. So antakkarana, having a limited size to the sharira but not anu and not being vyapaka, is siddhanta, but that is taken as being the atma itself by this navya nayayika. Ayam api paksha na samichinaha. So some of these nayayikas accept the atma to be expanding to the size of the sharira. Why? So why is it not valid? Atmanaha sankocha vikasa shalitva abhyupagami deepa prabhe prabha iva atma api vikari vinashicha sya. So you'll have atma which vikari. Once you accept any vikara for atma, it will become vinashi also. So shad vikara van atma vinashi api bhavati. Because of what reason? Vikaritva. Just because having any change, it will wither away. And then in time, Atma will undergo vinasha. Tatascha moksha pratipadaka shastrasya moksha sadhana anancha vayartham bhavet. So this Nayayika, who says Atma has a particular size as per the sharira, will have fallen out of shastra acceptance. That shastra is no longer valid, because moksha, which is said to be nitya, will not be nitya because atma itself is not nitya. So it is like saying you will get moksha but you won't be there. How ridiculous it is. Then the sadhana for moksha is also invalid. Shastra is invalid, moksha also is valid. So the moksha pratipadaka shastra as well as all sadhanas talked about by shastra, both are invalidated. Shastra and shastra showing these sadhanas, those sadhanas are also invalid. Madhyama parimadattvam atmanah angikritya sankocha vikasayor anangikare atma kena sharirena samana parimanah ityatra nishchayaka pramana bhavah. Now if the nayayika were to say, no, this Atma is Madhyama Parimana, all right, but you have misunderstood my paksha. Atma has a middle size. It is neither Anu nor Vyapaka. It is something in between. It is Nana, it is something in between. But then it is not going to expand. So Vikara Nasti. Your objection is that if Atma has Vikara, then it will become Vinashi. But my Atma is not Vikari at all. So you cannot say that it will become Vinashi. I'll explain it this way. So iti chet. Siddhanti says, okay, then you tell me, what is this Madhyama Parimana? What size is it exactly? So Atma has a particular size. Which size will it have? And on what basis? It is not expanding or shrinking. So let's say it has some size S. Atma's size is predefined as S. What is S size? Atma kena sharirena samana parimana. How do you say that the Atma size is S? Is it the size of the ant's body or the elephant's body or the human body? In that human also, which particular, whether it is the small elephant's body, a baby elephant or a grown-up elephant? Is it a size of a cub or is it a size of a full-grown animal? What size is this Atma now? So nischayaka pramana se abhava bhoti. There is no pramana to ascertain the size of atma. It is just some random statement, just like other statements of yours. Atmana manushya sharira samana parimanatva angikare. Let's say human beings have a particular size. Let's just give a range and accept that as around that size is this atma. Then what will happen? Yada atma hasti sharira vapnoti tada krishne sharira atmana bhavet. At least you must accept that human being has the heftiest or the biggest of human beings. Tallest and widest of human beings will still be smaller than an elephant. When this jivatma has gati, prarabdha says that the sharira should be, that jiva should have hasti sharira. And if elephant's body, that gaja sharira is huge. But being of a particular size of the earlier human being, atma, when it enters this gaja sharira, it will have only eka desha. It will have only a particular place in the sharira of gaja. It will not be spread throughout the elephant. Then what will happen? Same issues that you had with anuparimana. So pida anubhava is not possible yugapat across the sharira. Tatascha yatra deshe hastina atma nasti tatra pida anubhava nasyat. So you have got the same of anuparimana. Atma having anuparimana, you have landed in the same flaw which you tried to avoid by taking atma as madhyama parimana. Yadi hasti sharira samana parimana atma iti angikriyate, then you say that no, atma is of the size of the elephant. Tada hasti shariradapi bhrat shariram yada atma prapnoti tada tasya sharirasya ekadeshe purvoktaritya pidanubhavanasyat sarva sharirapekshaya bhrat parimanakam na kasyachidapi shariramasti yena samana parimanaka atma abhyugamyet. So if you say no, it is of the size of the elephant, then the atma, there may be bigger shariras which we don't know of, which are bigger than the elephant. Like the earlier case, you know, where there were dinosaurs. Or elsewhere in some other loka, there may be bigger sharira. Then what about that case? Same issue of this yugapat pida anubhava not being there. Will be there, that dosha will accrue there. If you say no, atma is of the size of the biggest of the shariras possible, that kind of a system cannot be explained at all. There is no sharira which is, if at all you say, then it will be Hiranyagarbha sharira. Then you have come to the mata of Vedantin. If you say there is only single atma, if you say there is, I mean, something closer, not exactly so. But then you cannot say atma is nana anymore because vyapaka flaws will accrue. Therefore, this system is also not acceptable. This kind of a nayayika mata is also not acceptable. Sarva sharira apeksha virat shariram brihat. So if you take virat sharira, parimana is atma. Atmana virat sharira samana parimana katvangikare virat sharire sarva sharira namantar bhutatva sarvesham atmanam sarvesh sharire sambandha siddha tatascha purvokta dosha avasthita eva. Then the vyapaka dosha of atma being vyapaka in the nayayika paksha and what? Being nana, then that same flaw will be there in your paksha also. So even if you avoid anuparimana and vyapaka parimana for atma, if you give it any parimana, then if it is shrinking and expanding atma, it will become vikari and then you have vinasha. Then what is the issue? Moksha shastra and moksha sadhana is useless. So you have shifted your darshana from astika darshana to nastika darshana. If you take atma to not being vikari, but madhyama parimana, meaning it will not shrink or expand, then which size does it have? Any size you take, it will have. If you take a smaller, then it will have the anuparimana dosha of yugapat pida anubhavasya asambhavah. if you take it as a huge sharira like virat sharira size for the atma, then same vyapaka dosha will also apply if you take nanatma. Meaning there will be yuga sukha dukha anubhava of all shariras. यद्वस्तु मध्यम परिमाण तदनित्यम शरीरवत इति नियम अस्ति. देन यू अप्लाई योर ओन न्याय. सो यत्र यत्र मध्यम परिमाणत्वम तत्र तत्र अनित्यत्वम यथा शरीरम यथा शरीरे. सो दिस व्याप्ति विल अप्लाई टू your paksha as wherever there is madhya parimana there is anityatvam. Like the sharira, sharira keeps on having, sharira does not have a ranu size, it does not have a brahat size vyapaka, sharira has a particular madhya parimana. Having the, you know, the medium, the sharira withers away. We have seen this, this vyapti will apply to your atma also, so atma will become anitya. तस्माद् आत्मापि मध्यमपरिमाणत्वाद् अनित्यो भवेत् वेदांत सिद्धांते तु अंतःकरण ज्ञानेन नश्यति अंतःकरणम्. सो इट शुड बी अंतःकरणम् हियर. सो वेदांत सिद्धांते तु अंतःकरणम् ज्ञानेन नश्यति. सो दिस नाशाय अदर्शनम्. नश अदर्शने अदर्शनम् मीन्स दिस दृग्दृश्य विवेक इज वेरी क्लियर. दृश्यत्वात् मिथ्या एंड देन मिथ्या दर्शन इज नो दर्शन आर यू. तस्माद् अंतःकरणम् अनित्यम् इन वेदांत सिद्धांत अंतःकरण मध्यम परिमाण अंतःकरण विल विदर अवे इन टाइम इट विल हैव नाशा वी डोंट हैव एन इश्यू. आत्मा इज एकश्च अंतःकरणस्य मध्यम परिमाणत्व अंगीकारे न दोष अस्ति इत्थं नवीन तार्किक मतम अपि असमीचीनम् एव. So Navyaneka's mata has also been refuted as Atma being Madhyama Parimana. This Nana is not, Nanatvam is not discussed at all because Madhyama Parimana is not acceptable. There are so many flaws. The flaws of Atma being Nana need not be shown at all there. It is assumed, you know, as an underlying current, but then when Vyapaka Paksha is taken, then Nanatvam is discussed. But otherwise, with Anu Parimana, kind of flaw you don't need the nanatva discussion in the madhyama parimana of atma. Sorry. So atmanah anuparimanatva vadi mata nirakaranam. Atma being anuparimana, what if the atma is of a small size? Antakarana is of a small size, atomic size. What if Atma is of atomic size? How? So that kind of vada is discussed here. Anye kechana nayayikaha Atma nana anuparimanascha ityahu. See, nayayikas need not be only these darshanikas. They may have taken other darshana also, and they are basically hidden logicians. So logicians have tried everything possible in logic and failed miserably because none of this explanation is valid. They'll have some logical flaw or the other. Not only Shruti Virodha, they'll have logical flaw also. That is why they are replacing the earlier with a newer version, what they call as new and improved. So new and improved Nyaya is also not standing scrutiny of logic itself. That is why they are trying to solve this issue just like science is trying to solve. Earlier science is replaced by newer one. Newer one cannot meet the complete goals. You have another version and yet another. So releases after releases, but you cannot have any conclusive end. There is no conclusive end because there is no nischaya possible. Because you cannot know the subject. Being the subject yourself, you cannot know the subject. Anything that is objectified differently by different subjects. When it is objectified differently, then there will be a flaw. One of them will be right. both can be wrong, but both cannot be right. So in this objectified prapancha, including manas, everything that is analyzed will be mit. And we don't care because our commitment is not there. Our commitment is to differentiate from that. We'll say maya sarvasya sambhavat. Okay, there are flaws in antakkarana. This way or that way. We agree with it. Yes, there are flaws. But our focus is not there. Our focus is to whether nana, eka, anuparimana. This is all a discussion to refute the other paksha, but we have no commitment to any of that. If you say no, this is not right, there are logical flaws, this is a better option, we say okay, you take that option. But only limited to antakarana, anatma. When you come to atma, you cannot land on it by anything other than shastra. No other pramana would work. So atmana anuparimanatva vadi mata nirakarana. If you take atma itself as having anuparimana, anuparimana like the antakarana, in the Nayayika Paksha, then what happens? Anye kechana Nayayika Atma Nana Anuparimanascha Ityahuhu. Sapi Vartana Yujyate. That will also not stand scrutiny. Why? Atma Karta Bhukta Chetyangikare Antakkaranasya Anutva Pakshe Yodoshaha Uktaha Saha Atra Api Prasajyeta. So Atma being Karta and Bhukta Antakkarana being Anu, whatever dosha was pointed out then, the same will accrue to this Atma being Anu Parimana. Atma Karta Bhukta Chetya Anangikare, Atmana Nanatva Angikara Nishpalo Bhavati. Now you say Atma is not Karta Bhukta, then what is the use of talking about many Atma? Atma is not Karta Bhukta, so why do you need many Atmas? It can be one as well. Let Antakarana be of whatever size be Karta Bhukta. Then that is the Advaita Siddhanta. So second paksha, if you take, you don't need Nanatva. You have to drop the Nanatma because Nanatva acceptance is not bringing additional benefit. So why don't you cross over into Vedanta? If you take the earlier paksha, then you have the same flaws. Vyapakasya ekasya atmana eva sarva sharira vrittitva angikara eva shreyan. Taking Atma as one and Vyapaka, that's the best solution even in logic. Atmana kartrutva bhuktrutva anangikare nayayikasya swasiddhanta tyagaha api bhavati. If the nayayika accepts that okay, Atma is not karta bhukta, he takes to the second paksha, then he has given up his nyaya paksha. He is not he is not giving you an improved version. He has given up the Nyaya Darshana itself. Not in the details. It is a fundamental change. Jnana Sukha Dukha Dharma Dharma Adaya Atma Dharma Iti Anuvadi Siddhantaha. So this Anuvadi Atma is Anu Parimana. There what does he say? Jnana Sukha Dukha Dharma, adharma, all these are Atma Dharmas. Tasmad Atmana Anutva Abhyupagame Yasmin Sharira Deshi Atma Nasti Sadeshaha Mruta Samano Bhavet Tatra Pidadyanuha Nasya. So the Anuparimana of Antakarana, whatever flaws, same flaws will accrue here in Atma being Anu. So not much to be discussed there. Atmanaha Anutvadinaha Akshepaha Tat Samadhanam Atmanaha Vachi Shruti Tatparyancha. Now, Nayayikas, all sorts of Nayayikas have heard all sorts of refutations by the Siddhanti. Now, all of them have questions. So, you have pointed out flaws in our system. How does it work in yours? So, you cannot just keep on showing that no, you are wrong. You are also wrong. Everybody is wrong. I am right. Why? You give me the right paksha then. What is the right interpretation of the Shruti which talks about Atma being Anu? Sukshma. Sukshma is also size. As per the Nayayikas, Sukshma can mean size. So it's a small size Atma. This is what Shruti says. So you call us as falling off from Shruti and becoming Nastikas. What about you? You, the Vedanti, who always calls himself as following the Shastra, please explain, how do you explain this Anutva Vachi Shruti? What is the tatpare of that Shruti? Shruti talks of Atma being. Why don't you explain and show how you are you keeping in with the Shastra? How are you in line with the Shastra and we have fallen off? So Akshepas and their Samadhanas are shown here in the 364th Avarta. Atha yadyuchyate, yadyapi atma sharirasya ekadeshe vartate, tathapi kasturi kamoda vadatmanaha jnanam krishnam shariram vyapnoti. Tatascha krishne sharire anukula pratikulayo sambandhasya anubhava bhavati iti. Now this atma can be there in ekadesha of the sharira. So earlier what was said is atma is anu. Now this atma is anu, you say, you the Siddhanti, show me a flaw as to what atma being anu, you cannot have pida anu, which is there in the other part of the sharira. How about that pida reach the atma? Atma may be in one place. Thus, yadyapi atma sharirasya ekadeshi eva vartate. The anutva vadi atmanaha anutva is accepted by this nayayika. But in your objection, you are saying that atma cannot have pida anubhava in other deshas where atma is not there. He says that why not? You have an example, kasturi kamodavat. Let's say the kasturi chandana, let's say the chandana is there somewhere. So your nose is else, chandana is elsewhere. It is not connected, but the chandana's fragrance reaches you. So let the pida be elsewhere in the sharira, atma be in some other place in the sharira, ekadesha, but let the pida, like the fragrance, reach the nose. Like the fragrance reaches the nose, similarly, the pida reaches the atma. Or vice versa, also, if you extend it, you say atma being in one place also, it may have the pida anubhava without actually being present there. Just like fragrance overreaches. Wherever it is, the fragrance is not limited to that chandana area. It reaches further and further. So tatascha, so tathapi kasturi kamodavat atmana jnanam krishnam shariram vyapnoti. But what is he saying? This chetana, not the other way. The pida does not reach here is all. But he says that the jnana, the chetana reaches throughout the sharira like the fragrance reaches elsewhere. And thereby pida anubhava is possible. Why not? Why not have it this way? Tatascha krishne sharire anukula pratikulayo sambandhasya anubhava bhavati iti. So whatever is, there is a, so you have the skin is burnt due to heat. So you prefer that cold touch now because there is the body is feeling heat there. You put or whatever, you know, you walk in an AC room or whatever, and then you feel better from the outside heat. There is no. So anukula or pratikula, the heat outside the body, that outside the house was, house or office was not tolerable, but it was felt although the atma was in one desha, one particular part of the sharira, still the entire sharira is feeling the heat from the sun. That is possible because the chetana, jnana of atma which is in one particular area, it reaches out like the fragrance throughout the body. Similarly, when you walk in, then the cool breeze is pervading the sharira outside you, but Atma being in one place also, the cool breeze throughout the sharira because of jnana reaching out like fragrance reaches out. So that is the anukula pratikulayo sambandhasya anubhava bhavati eva. Tadapi ayuktam eva. That is also not acceptable. Why? Yatra guni dravyam asti tatreva gunaha vartate. You are a nayayika. What kind of an argument is this? What is your explanation for guna guni sambandha? So dravya has, therefore that dravya is guni dravya. So gunaha asya asti dravyasya iti matup. So you add matup, matup arthe ini. So ini prathe is added matup arthe. Tadasya asmin va asti. So in this dravya, there is guna. So this dravya becomes guni dravya. Guni, yatra guni dravya masti. Now this guni dravya, where it is? It is in a particular desha. Eka desha is accepted. Tatreva gunaha vartate. So where will this jnana be? Jnani atma. Anuparimana atma. Jnani atma has chetanatva. It can have jnanotpatti due to some sambandha that is held. Jnana will be utpanna in the atma when there is some sambandha, or jnana is there in the atma for whatever reason, but still it will be there in the same place where atma is. This atma in your case happens to be anuparimana. So the guna will also be there. This jnana guna, which you say jnana krutnam shariram vyapnoti, that will not be possible because this jnana is what? Atmanaha. Atmanaha jnanam guna bhavati. There this guna has to be limited to atma, which is what? It is anuparimana. How can this guna pervade the sharira? Krutnam shariram katam vyapnoti. Na vyapnoti. Why? Guni dravyam yatra asti tatra eva gunaha vartate. So jnanam yatra atma vartate anuparimanatvena sharirasya ekadeshe yatra atma vartate tatra eva jnana gunaha vartate. It cannot be elsewhere. Tatha atmana jnanam api atmana anyatra na syat. It will not expand to the sharira because atma is not expanding to the sharira. If you say atma expand to the sharira, then you are the Madhyama Parimana Vadi, not Anu Parimana Vadi. But then he asks, how does it work in the Kasturi? In the Chandra case, how does it work? There, fragrance goes elsewhere. Why not Jnana go? Kasturi Kayaha Sukshmaha Bhaga Yavantam Desham Vyapnoti Tavantam Meva Desham Kasturi Kamodo Vyapnoti. So in the case of your example also, what is happening? That sukshma bhaga of the chandana, the particles are reached beyond the kasturi chandana, which is seen by your eyes. Wherever you see that being there in the particular area, you cannot see the sukshma bhaga. The sukshma bhaga is scattering here and there. So the particles are there. Wherever the particles are reaching, so far the sugandha will be there. It won't be there beyond that area. You cannot have chandana in a shop and smell it outside. You can smell it outside only as, you know, if there is a lot of chandana, then you can smell it a little further. You know, people may say, you know, the oldest Mysore chandana soap, whatever, you know, that factory is there. You can smell chandana in the area nearby. But if you go beyond, it is not going to reach Bangalore, sir. So it is not that it is going to reach everywhere. So wherever the particles reach, so far is the reach of the tasmat kasturika drishtanta atra na ghatate. that exam is not befitting the exemplified, you cannot establish Atma Jnana being pervasive towards the Sharira, each and every part, or pervading each and every part of the Sharira with the example of Kasturi, because Kasturi particles are reaching only a particular area, and that particular area you can have the Atashchamanuhu iti paksha api ayukta eva. So that is also not a valid paksha. Kvachit shrutav atma atyanta anu anoho api anuhu iti yaduchyate. So Nayayika says, now then why does Shruti talk about atma being anu? We are going by the Shruti. So final, see, he has used all logic. All sorts of logics have failed. Now he says, no, Shruti talks about it. So Shruti is a fallback pramana for them. So he brings up Shruti now. He says, no, Shruti talks about it. So you are having Shruti Virodha, not me. So kvache shrutavu atma atyantano rapyanuhu iti yaduchyate. Tad atma durnyatva viprayana ukta. So that atyanta anorapi anuhu is an arthavada. It is only a way of expressing. It's a figurative statement. It is a figurative statement. It is not idamittham. It is not talking about the size. It is talking about sukshmatvam, not as size. Anu means sukshma. Sukshma because it is not easily understandable. Just like you miss small, you can miss these subtle things. This is subtler than the subtlest, so it is very easy to miss. Very difficult to understand. So durnyatva avipraayana uktam. Atma is very difficult to know. Yatha atyanta anuvastunam mandadrishtinam purushanam na sambhavati. Tatha bahirbukhanam purushanam atmajnanam na bhavati. So anuttvam is sukshmatvam. Sukshmatvam is durnyat. For those who have mandadrishti, for them this jnana of atyanta anu vastu is not very subtle to understand. So how will they get Atmajnana? Unless their mandadrushti is refined, the buddhi is refined, they won't understand it. Then that is what the Shruti means by saying Atma Atyanta Anurapya. Tasmad Anusamana Atma Ityeva Shrutehe Tatparyam Na Anu Parimana Iti. This size is not being discussed. What is discussed in the Shruti is Anu Samana Atma. That Samanyam is Niyatvam. Niyatva Samanyena Anu Ityuchyate Natu Parimana Samanyena. Parimana is not being talked about at all. Mahato Mahi Jayana Akashat Mahan Vibhum Atmanam Sayeshu Ananto Paryantaha Ityadina Bahushu Staleshu Shrutya Eva Atmana Vyapakatva, because you are being very picky. Even in the Upanishad, when it is said Anuraniyan, immediate next statement is Mahato Mahiyan. So don't hold on to what is smaller than the smallest and what is bigger than the biggest. If you take the small size as the meaning of, then smaller than the smallest is what the Shruti says. This is what your perspective is. What about bigger than the biggest in the very next statement? Just by showing that Atma is smaller than the smallest as well as bigger than the biggest, that itself says that Atma cannot have a size. Otherwise, it is a logical flaw. Logically, you cannot have something which is smaller than the smallest as well as bigger than the biggest. But the same Atma, which is not two, same Atma is explained to be smaller than the smallest, bigger than the biggest. That means that the small and big sizes are not being discussed. What is being said is that it is not quantifiable in size, not measurable in size. So it is beyond the size limits. It cannot be. So it cannot be size. It is the subtlety which is being talked about. Purnatvam which is being mentioned. Subtle but purna. That purna tattva is very subtle. It cannot be easily understood. That is what the श्रुति तात्पर्य इज सो किम तात्पर्य श्रुतेः यू कैनॉट हैव स्टेटमेंट्स विच आर कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी वेयर देर आर कॉन्ट्राडिक्शंस दोज आर एपरेंट यू हैव टू इंटरप्रिट देम श्रुति कैनॉट हैव विरोध विथ इट्स ओन स्टेटमेंट्स ज्यायान आकाशात परवेजिव तत्व इज बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट महांतम विभु विभु मात्र एज अ कर्म देयर द ओनली पार्ट ऑफ इट इज कोटेड सैश अनंतः अपर्यंतः देयर इज नो लिमिट सो दैट काइंड ऑफ अनंत तत्व इन्फिनिट आत्मा कैनॉट बी सेड टू बी अणुपरिमाण इत्यादिना बहुषु स्थलेषु श्रुत्या एव आत्मन व्यापकत्व प्रतिपादनात् दिस हेतु दैट कैनॉट बी अणु अणुत्व कैनॉट बी अणु अणोरणीयान महतो महीयान इति श्रुतेः अयम आशय सो व्हाट इज द आइडिया व्हेन श्रुति सटलर देन द सटलेस्ट एंड बिगर देन द बिगेस्ट पृथ्वी अपेक्षया जलम सूक्ष्म व्यापकंच जलात् तेज सूक्ष्म व्यापकंच सो कंपेयर्ड टू पृथ्वी विच इज वेरी इजीली आइडेंटिफाइबल वेरी इजीली अंडरस्टूड Because all of the sense organs can objectify Prithvi. Although Gandhavati Prithvi, Prithvi as Gandha. But once it is put together, Panchikruta, all these are Panchikruta. But Prithvi has all the five gunas. The subtler Prithvi has all the five gunas. Jala has four gunas. Tejas has three gunas. Vayu has two gunas. Akash has one guna. The unmanifest Maya has no guna. Although we say Trigunatmika Maya, that those gunas are not these objectifiable gunas. Akasha can be Akasha se Shabda. So by Shabda you know Akasha. By touch you know Sparsha, you know Vayu. By Rupa you know Tejas. Others also. By touch also you can know Agni, Tejas is Agni. So Agni Rupa is seen, Vayu Rupa is not seen. However, Agni also has Vayu Guna, Sparsha. So Agni can be felt by Sparsha also. It will burn you. That is the Vayu Guna which is pervading into the next created element. Manifest element which is Agni or Tejas. It also has Shabda. So there is a bhugu bhugu sound which is when the fire comes up, there is a sound which is the Akashas Guna. So each and every manifest, next manifest Padartha Mahabhuta will have the earlier Guna also. So Prithvi happens to have all the five Gunas. Jala has four and so on. So this is the Prithvi is very easy to cognize. Because all five sense organs will work there. So on unmanifest, when you go to unmanifest Maya, there is no Shabda Guna also. Trigunatmika Maya is not Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. Sattva, Rajas and Tamas are unmanifest gunas. Unless they are manifest, you cannot know Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. In the Antakarana, by the Kriya, you know what is Sattva Guna. In Gitacharya, talks about it. How do you know Sattva Guna? Ityadi. So this Anuraniyan Mahatomayan, what is it explaining? Prithivi apekshaya jalam sukshmam vyapakancha. Compared to Prithivi, jala is sukshma because it has one less guna and it is more vyapaka. Karana is always more vyapaka than karya. And similarly, jala tejas sukshmam vyapakancha, tejaso vayu sukshmam vyapakascha, vayu rakasha sukshmam vyapakascha, akashan maya sukshma vyapikacha. Maya apeksha atma sukshma vyapakascha. So atma is subtler than maya also. Ityevam shrutishu atmana sarva apekshaya sukshmatvam vyapakatvamcha. Sukshmatvam kaya drishtya. So this anoho aniyan, when you take this part, anor aniyan, smaller than the smallest, more sukshma than the most sukshma that you know of. What is that? Maya. So anuttvam being talked about in shastra is to talk about sukshmatvam. Sarvapekshaya sukshmatvam atmanaha. Then what about mahatamaya? Oh, vyapakatvam, purnatvam. So both are not contradictory because it is sukshma and vyapaka. That's what is being talked about by saying anuho aniyan mahataha mahiyan. Ayam artha upadesha sasri granthe bhagavat pade utaha tatha chatma anuho ichyangikaro nishpalaha. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara Bhagavat Padacharya talks about it in Upadesha Sahasri. So Atma Anu, as Anu meaning having the Anu Sai, is Nishprayojana, it is Nishphala. तस्माद् आत्मा न अनुपरिमाणः एवञ्च आत्मा व्यापको नाना च आत्मा मध्यमपरिमाणो नाना च आत्मा अनुपरिमाणः नाना च इति उक्तयः अत्यन्तम् असंगता. सो ऑल दीज व्यू पॉइंट्स वेयर आत्मा इज ऑल परवेसिव एंड आत्मास आर मेनी एंड दे आर ऑल परवेसिव दैट इज नॉट वैलिड. What about Atma being Madhya Parimana and having a middle size of the Sharira? That is also not possible. Why? We saw the flaws. If Vyapaka and Nana, then one of the things we saw is what? Sukha Dukkha Anubhava cannot be segregated. Karma Vyavastha cannot be segregated. In the second, logically, okay, let's take Atma as Madhya Parimana and Nana. There the problem is, either you'll have the flaws of Yugapat Pida Anubhava not being possible if it has a particular size, or if you say it shrinks and expands, then Vikarityat Vinashi also. Moksha and Moksha Sadhana will be useless. Moksha Shastra and Moksha Sadhana will be useless. If you say it is not having a Vikara, then having a particular size, Anya Desha Pida Anubhava will not be possible. Anya Sharira. Anya Sharira Desha, your own Sharira, you can feel Pida only in one particular part or some particular parts, not throughout the body. And if it is the huge size, then again you cannot say like Virat Sharira, it has a huge size. Otherwise, same issues of Vyapakatva will apply there. Sukha Dukkha Anubhava of all Shariras will be Anubhuta by each and every. Then Atma Anuparimanaha Nana Cha. This third also should be in quotation there. It is not quoted. So this Atma of a small atomic size and many also not possible. Why? Because same flaw as being limited to a particular area of the Sharira, you will not have Sukha Dukkha the Pida Anubhava of the entire Sharira. So Siddhanta Pradarshanam, then what is the real Siddhanta? Atma Ekaha Vyapakaha. Atma is one and Vyapaka, all pervasive, Purna, Ananta. Sukadayaha Antakarana Dharmaha. This Sukadukhadi, Jnana, all this that you talk about, Vrittitvena, all those are Antakarana Dharmas. Antakarana Upahita Atmani Kalpitaha. Then how is this Atma Sambandha, etc.? There is no Atma Sambandha at all. They are all imagined in Atma. And in the same Atma, imagined by association with a particular Antakarana, there is particular Antakarana Dharmas in Atma. Parisheshyat Atma Ekaha Vyapakascha. So all these options of Atma being Nana and of various size, none of those are fitting. Logically also they are flawed. So you go back to what other option is possible. So parishesha nyaya. What remains then? Prasaktanam bahunam madhye itara nishede sati yadavashishyate tad visheka nishchaya parisheshyam nityuchyate. What remains after all the other pakshas are refuted, what remains is parishesha. प्रसक्त प्रतिषेधे अन्यत्र अप्रसंगा शिष्यमाणे संप्रत्या इति श्लोक व्याख्या रूप सो समथिंग मेंशन समवेयर सो ही इज गिविंग दी लक्षण पारिशेष्यात् आत्मा एकः व्यापकश्च सो आत्मा डज नॉट हैव अ साइज पर से एंड आत्मा नीड नॉट बी मेनी व्हेन यू टेक आत्मा एज व्यापक बिकॉज अंतकरणस आर मेनी एंड लिमिटेड यू कैन हैव every vyavastha explanation by the logically also shruti talks about it but we can logically explain as well atmani dharma dharma sukha dukha bandha mokshanam angikare keshanchit sukham keshanchit dukham keshanchit bandha keshanchit mokshascha iti vyavaharo na siddhyet if you accept atmani dharma dharma sukha dukha ityadi if you accept atma having these dharmas then some cannot have sukha some cannot have dukha some cannot have bandha some cannot have moksha that vyavahara is not going to be possible atah dharmadaya buddher dharmaha they are antakarana dharma yadyapi buddher jadatva tatrapi dharma sukha tatrapi dharma sukadaya na yujyante tathapi tesham atma आत्मधर्मत्वं न संभवति इत्यभिप्रायेण बुद्धिधर्मत्वोक्तिर् इति ज्ञेयम् दे आर नॉट रियली बुद्धिधर्म आल्सो रियली इफ यू इंक्वायर इनटू इट दे कैन नॉट बी देयर कैन नॉट बी सुख इन बुद्धि विच इज जड़ा यू कैन नॉट से माय अंतकरण इज सुख देयर इज अ सुख प्रत्यय दैट प्रत्यय इज आल्सो पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन लेंड्स इट एग्जिस्टेंस एंड स्फूर्ति So, Satta Spurti is being lent by Atma by mere presence. Otherwise, by itself, Buddhi also cannot be said to be having Sukhadi Dharmas. Why? Tesham Atma Dharvatvam na sambhavati Jadatva Buddher Jadatva They cannot be the Buddhi dharma also na sambhavati ityavi prayana. So atma dharma it cannot be. So then buddhi dharma also it cannot be jadatvat. Still it is mentioned that atma dharma it isn't. You can take it to be buddhi dharma. Although it isn't buddhi dharma also. You cannot take it as atma dharma because shruti virodha is there and no vyavastha can be. Everywhere you have flaws. So atma cannot be said to have can buddhi be said to have dharmas strictly speaking buddhi also cannot have these dharmas because buddhi is jada it cannot have sukha anubhava you have no other choice but to explain it that way then you refute it later but then idea is to not analyze and conclude that what does buddhi have Our idea is to say, I am not the Buddhi. I don't have any of these dharmas. I let it out. Once you throw away the garbage, you don't go on find as to where is this garbage put. We don't care. We treat all these dharmas finally as garbage. Garbage has to be chucked out. We don't care how it is sorted. We have no business with the garbage. So once you have thrown it out as not as Atma Dharma, It is all right. When you're discussing, you ask Nayayika said it is here. They discuss it, sort out, and you say it is not possible. You bring back the focus on Atma. Once you have the focus back to Atma, then we don't care dharmas which are thrown out where they really belong. If they don't belong here also, we don't care. You call them tuchha for all I care. We don't value them at all. Our tatparya is to understand Atma Dharma. Is it or is it not? If it is not, we are done. We don't go into details of where they belong. That is the commitment there. So yadyapi buddher jadatva tatrapi dharma sukha dukhadaya na yujyante tathapi tesham atma dharvatvam na sambhavati ityabhiprayena buddhi dharmatva uktiriti jnyam. It is just mentioned so to take it away from atma. Whether it is possible or not in buddhi even if it is not possible you take it that way we don't care te buddhi dharma iti na abhiprayah we don't say that they are buddhi dharma if you go and talk to someone who is interested in anatma analysis they can spend their entire life but not be able to conclude. We don't want to waste our life there. We say we have no tatparya there at all. So we'll continue the Siddhanta analysis in the next part, huh? By Guhadikarana, Bhashya Anusari Idam Vakyam. It is taking cue from Brahma Sutra. There is mentioned, we don't go into more details on where do these dharmas reside. Further, we don't have a possibility analysis. In fact, others won't have this objection at all. We say that from Siddhanta, they cannot even be Buddhi Dharma. Just for accuracy, mention that, our commitment is not there. Others won't have an issue. Others won't have an issue as to where do these dharmas really reside. Sukhan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Dhakyatu Nirmalam Aparam Sar Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Param Maha Tadeva Hannamatto Nirti Menichitamatihi. Tatsa. Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste.